here and behind me is a new listing of mine here in San Diego, California, in the Mission Bay Marina. This is a 2002 Beneteau 361. So let me show you some of the features and benefits that this boat has to offer. Okay, so here we are looking at Wind Angel, the 2002 Beneteau 361 that's here in Mission Bay. As you can see, she is a beautiful boat. It has a bimini, a dodger, in-mast furling. And then as we go up, we can see a double spreader mast with Raymarine radar, wind point, wind speed at the top. There's a whisker pole as well too. You have the aluminum continuous tow rails around the vessel, and she is in really good condition for its age. Coming up here to the front, you can see the upgraded rocknet anchor. We also have a tack attachment point. So if you were to fly an A-sail, that's included as well. The vessel is equipped with a folding propeller and really is quite a nice, you know, pocket cruiser. Great boat for Mission Bay, San Diego Bay, Catalina Island, and some great adventures. So as we come aboard the vessel, you can see it has a large cockpit. We have a nice bimini here, Dodger. This has been upgraded macrolong glass, stainless steel grab handle here, large traveler forward of the Dodger. And as we move our way up forward, again, you can see lots of deck space, opening hatches. The dinghy is rolled up and mounted here on the foredeck. We have a large, for this size boat, windlass and a large anchor locker. And again, it's really well thought out. Making our way back aft. Again, all of the sheets and halyards are let into the cockpit. Adjustable Genoa tracks here on the side deck, which makes it really nice to get to that extra angle of your sail. We have the outboard engine lift here with the outboard. I love these stern rail seats that come down. And again, as we work our way back aft, what's really nice about this is this center seating area here drops down. So it gives you a nice walk throughout to the transom of the vessel. We have our swim step ladder here, shore power connectors. There's a barbecue mounted here as well too. And just a great use of space. So right here at the helm, over to the starboard side, we're looking at the engine hours. Our 922 engine hours is our RPM display here. We have the Raymarine wheel mounted pilot. And then also, which has been recently upgraded, we have the Raymarine autopilot control head unit, multi-repeater. This is depth and speed. And then we also have the newer hybrid touchscreen GPS plotter here. Throttle controls off to starboard side, built-in cup holders, compass. And down below, this lazaret locker is a massive storage area that goes from the backside of the galley all the way on the port side of the vessel. Working our way back up, we have all of the sheets, as I mentioned, leading into the cockpit here with two winches. You can also, before I get too far, you can also tell that they've recently upgraded the jib sheets here and some of the running rigging. And we'll move our way down below. Three gradual steps, galley off to the port side here. The galley's quite nice. Again, for the size of the vessel, you have lots of headroom. So I'm about 6 foot and I have about 3 inches over my head in certain areas, and quite nice. We have a large shelving area here for a refrigerator. We also have a top loading refrigerator here with a cold plate. And then there's a built-in microwave. And then so from here aft, this is that huge lazaret locker that I was telling you about. Lots of shelving and storage. We have a two burner stove and oven. This is really cool. This is a massive storage area here for the galley. So you can, again, fit in, you know, dishes and food, what have you. Additional storage, trash below here, the double stainless steel sinks. Directly across from the galley is access to our dayhead and access to the aft cabin. So let me start you out there as we work our way into the aft cabin. Again, notice the headroom as it carries all the way through here. Great size berth. This aft cabin is quite nice because it does offer you a great sleeping area. I would say feet down there, head here, because you have the headroom above, which I really like. And then you have a full hanging locker here. There are three opening hatches and one fixed port off to the outboard side. And as we move our way up forward, you have a separate head and shower compartment. This is a upgraded Japsco freshwater electric toilet, so it's all push button, which is quite nice. You have your sink here, vanity, and a full walk-in shower with a seat compartment here and a little shower curtain that'll encompass this area. So pretty nice, and again, good headroom all the way throughout here and directly across from that. The galley, as we've seen before, but a little different perspective. You have additional storage on the outbound sides of it. What I really like is these built-in fiddles here, so you have grab handles. You know, it really gives you a nice secure area. So looking up forward, a beautiful, off-white, ultra leather seating. This salon table does turn down into a berth. There's a filler cushion for that. And then you have a forward-facing nav station. So the nav station set up with easy access to your macerator, breaker switch here, windlass controller, your inverter controller, stereo, VHF. And what I like about this Icon VHF is you also have a command mic here that plugs in at the helm, so you have full control for your VHF. We have our panel here. This will kind of pretty much indicate battery voltage and all of our 12-volt breakers. We have, again, the hybrid touchscreen, GPS plotter, and Vectron Energy battery monitor. So that's kind of encompassing the nav station. And again, directly across this large, U-shaped seating, large bench seat here. They've done a nice job with these little peekaboo little shades here on the opening ports. Overhead opening hatch there, a Samsung television mounted on the starboard head bulkhead, excuse me. And then as we move up to the V-berth, just behind the door here is a little bench seat that you can sit down, put your shoes on, but a nice V-berth here and a full hanging locker closet. There is a little portable dish dome that you can use to watch TV, and then a DVD player. But overhead opening hatch and two side ports that make this forward cabin have a good ventilation and airflow. Looking back aft kind of gives you a different perspective of just, how open this 36 footer is. And again, really impressive, good condition. Engine is mounted down below. You'll see from some of the pictures what that looks like. It has an upgraded alternator on it as well too. All right, well, I hope you found the video to be helpful and informative. If you would like additional information on this 2002 Beneteau 361, please feel free to contact myself at any time, day or night. If you liked the video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't already, subscribe to my channel for additional video walkthroughs like this and seeing the boats before they even come on the MLS. Thank you again for watching, and I look forward to hopefully earning your business.